Hello and welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a deal. The layout of the application really mimics the one of a contract. So I really wanted to have something that looks like a paper contract. It's composed out of a series of clauses that a user has to accept in order for him to validate a contract. So as you can see, the let's make a deal, so the submit button is inactivated until all the clauses are accepted by the client. In the first clause, the clause 0, I'm explaining to the client that the prices displayed to him on screen will all be converted to USD. In order to do so, I'm fetching the last ETH to USD conversion rate from a Chainlink Oracle. As you can see, the last conversion rate that was fetched was on January the 1st, a long time ago. This is because I haven't initialized the this variable at this point, so I just deployed the contract. And default value was assigned to the conversion rate, but not to the last timestamp the conversion rate was fetched. So the first thing I propose to do is fetching the last conversion rate from the Chainlink data feed. So I'm going to confirm the transaction, and you will see it will be updated. Here we are working on Ring B, so each transaction will take a certain time to be executed. Voilà, it's the case, and as we can see, I got the last conversion rate today, and it's updated in the front end. You can click on the link to see the last calls that were made to the Oracle. In order to make this happen, I'm actually implementing the aggregator vector interface. Everything is well explained in the Chainlink docs. Behind the scene, Chainlink is averaging the ETH price of trustful blockchain actors. Let's accept this first clause and continue with the second one, so the clause one. In this clause, we are explaining to the user that the price he will actually pay to create a deal will be conditioned by the number of additional accounts and additional rules that will compose his deal. So now here you can see the accounts and the rules. To execute the rule on MAT, the client will have to pay 1% of the total MSG value transmitted to the rule as fees paid directly to the contract plus some gas costs. A rule will only be executed if a minimal MSG value is associated with it, otherwise it will be reverted. Now, let's create our accounts. In order to facilitate the deal creation process, I've created a table in which you can label all the addresses that will be part of the deal. As you can see in line 0, the MetaMask selected account will always be part of the deal, as is the deal creator. I have already labeled my accounts in MetaMask. I'm just gonna go through all them and copy their addresses and label them correctly. It will be very helpful when creating the rules in Clause 5. All the accounts have been defined. If I validate the clause 4 now, the clause 1 creation, the deal creation fees will be updated accordingly. So now we can see that we have 6 accounts, which totals to $150. Now let's create a rule. I will create a first rule that will be used by the accountant in order to pay the employee's salaries. So this rule is only available to the accountant, that's why I have added the if ADR instructions in which I have specified that the account that is the one that is supposed to execute it. If anyone else tries to execute it, it will simply revert. Now I'm splitting the if value among the different employees, and to make it a bit more interesting, I'm going to split it unequally. Voilà, 35% for the first employee, 35% for the second, and 30% for the last one, which totals to 100%. I'm going to create a new rule for the owner, the contract owner, that he will use to pay the bonuses to the accountant and to the chairman. So 30% for the accountant and 70% to the chairman. And as you can see, it will only work if the amount transmitted as an MHG value is bigger than 0.5 ETH. Getting ETH on RinkB is a troublesome process. So if you decide to play around on that on RinkB, I will create a rule that will allow any account to send to the main account the ETH back. Please note that it is always possible to delete a single line from the table if you made a mistake. So I'm deleting a line, but you can also delete a whole rule. Now we are done. I will validate the clause 5, get back to clause 1, so we have three rules. The table has been updated, as well as the total price. Now we can finally accept the clause 1 and trigger the deal creation. Voilà, let's click on the button. The MetaMask window is open, and you see that the fees correspond to the deal creation fees in the screen. Voilà, plus some gas. Let's give it a few seconds. And voila, that's done. A new frame has opened in which you can find the deal ID that will be used to execute it and some information about the block, the transaction, and also the transaction initiator, which is the MetaMask selected account. If you click on any of the links in the frame, you will be sent to Etherscan, on which you will be able to see details about the transaction. Let's, for example, see the events that were emitted. So the first event corresponds to the deal creation. We will see the deal ID, so the deal 0. And below, we will see the message that was sent for the deal creation fees. So how much fees were paid to the contract. That's it for this video. In the next one, I'm going to show you how to actually execute a rule from the deal. Thank you for your time.